Nobody wants to get united. Like, what we gotta do is meet everybody at home 49th Street at the bench.
Welcome back, ladies and gentlemen. Should you practice throw-ups? That's the big question for today's video. Now, I don't mean that question the way you might think. You might hear that and immediately say, well, yeah, obviously, and I'd agree with you, 100%. However, that's not quite how I mean it. Alright, so what do I mean? Now, if any of you guys have been doing graffiti for any amount of time, you've probably heard old school graffiti artists always say, myself included, practice hand styles, throw-ups, then pieces. Let's talk about why old school graffiti artists always say to go from hand styles, throw-ups, to pieces. The reason this happens is because that's how things were literally created. That's the order, that's the chronological order that those three things were made in. So old school graffiti artists had no choice but to practice hand styles first because literally nothing else existed. And then of course when throw-ups came along, all they had was throw-ups and hand styles, so of course they went from hand styles to throw-ups. And then from there, they went to pieces because pieces were created after throw-ups. Now it also makes a lot of logical sense in order to go ahead and practice hand styles first and then practice throw-ups and then practice pieces. So doing it this way allowed you to kind of understand and practice how you're gonna go ahead and do your fill-in, how you're gonna do fatter and larger letters without having all the commitment that a piece would have. It was still simplistic enough, it was still easy enough to where you can literally just throw it up on a wall without having to really worry too much about it. And this is great. This is amazing. And it has a lot of utility. And while I recommend this process, you know, practicing hand styles, then throw up some pieces, I want to go ahead and introduce something a little bit different. I really think graffiti art should be practicing all three simultaneously. And this is the major difference here with a focus on hand styles and straight letters. Now understand, don't get me wrong, you should certainly be doing all three of them at the same time, right? You do a little bit of hand styles one day, maybe tomorrow you feel like doing throw-ups, you do some throw-ups, that's perfectly fine. And then maybe like 30 minutes after that, you want to do some straight letters, go ahead and rock those. But I think people should focus on learning hand styles and straight letters. And the reason I believe this is because those two different forms of graffiti have a lot more in common as far as their formulas and how they function than throw-ups have. You see, one of the key features, one of the fundamental sets of throw-ups is that they lack negative space. So there's usually heavy overlapping letters. As for hand styles, they'll have a little bit more negative space, and pieces, once again, they'll have a little bit more negative space. And throw-ups also have a large amount of letter and aim weight that you usually don't see in hand styles and pieces. And did I mention the massive lack of negative space? And with that lack of negative space, that's gonna bring us to letter and name positioning, which these things inevitably affect letter structure. And that doesn't even consider the fact that letter structure is already being distorted by the fact that simpler throw-ups have rounder letter structures, so like that you can do them faster. So with that, throw-ups are a very huge departure from the normal norm of graffiti. And it's when practicing throw-ups that a lot of graffiti artists don't yet understand and can't differentiate these fundamental sets between each different form of graffiti, which they end up taking lessons from throw-ups and applying the wrong lessons to their pieces. This inevitably causes newer graffiti artists to be very confused when doing straight letters because now the information from hand styles is detached from straight letters. The lessons you're supposed to bring over from throw-ups to pieces is supposed to be the lessons you get from painting on a wall. You know, things like being able to scale your letters properly, outlining, filling in, stuff like that. That's the stuff that throw-ups helps you do. The things that you're supposed to bring over from hand styles to pieces is how the actual structure functions and how the science behind the letters function and how all of the fundamentals function. That's what you're supposed to bring over from hand styles to straight letters. So that's why I go ahead and say people should, yes, practice all three of them the way old school New York graffiti artists intended, but focus the formula from hand styles into the formula to straight letters because they have a direct correlation to one another. There is not a direct correlation with the science behind throw-ups and the science behind pieces. Once again, the overlap there is supposed to be the transition to a wall. It's supposed to be how you scale your letters. It's supposed to be how you paint on a wall with spray paint. That's the overlap between those two things. Hopefully that sheds some light. Hopefully that kind of clarifies the intention behind this kind of practice, and it kind of clarifies the use behind practicing the way old school graffiti artists practice, right? Hand styles, throw-ups, straight letters. And it shows you kind of where to put the pieces of the puzzle. Anyway, guys, that's gonna bring us to today's video. Let me know your thoughts in the comments down below. What's the hardest form of graffiti for you? For those of you guys who are new here, feel free to subscribe and come out with 2 videos a week. And I'd love to have you guys in the next one. Anyway, I'll catch you guys next time. Have yourself a great day. Peace.